one of those episodes of sitting on a park bench there, and waiting for the cameras to roll. And Zach says to me, he says, I'm writing a film. I said, you're a busy boy. He said, I want to use one of your songs as a soundtrack. I said, go ahead, you do that. So we did. And the soundtrack went platinum, which... you're dazzling me in the lights there with your iPad. It's all there. Are you coming for me? Or is it just your bling you're wearing? I can't tell. Are you done with that?
Platinum.
Yeah, went platinum. The song was also on an album of mine in 1997 called Transcendental Highway, which did not go platinum. I think it may have reached...
Copper?
No, mahogany. Mahogany status. It's a fine wood, but hardly. The good thing about having a song on a platinum selling CD is you get money in the mail.
Right.
Nothing better than that, is it? Unexpected money in the mail. The only thing that's better than that is when you go to the doctor and you have one of those colonoscopy things. Oh. And you come out of the twilight and the doctor says to you, your bum's okay. That is a good day right there. But getting money in the mail comes a close second. It's no good getting money in the mail if your bum's not okay. Some people don't care about their bum. Not me. Just in case you're wondering how much money you make if you have a song and a platinum selling CD, you can't retire on it. So don't go to the Bahamas, sell up and go, right, I'm off to the Bahamas. But if you're thinking of renovating your kitchen, go right ahead. I was renovating my kitchen a few years ago, and the contractor was standing in the kitchen. He goes, well, what do you want to do, Mr. A? You want to go with the real granite or the fake granite? And I was going through the mail at the time, and I came upon this envelope from Sony Music, and I opened up, and I said, what did you say? He said, do you want to go with the real granite or the fake granite? I went, fuck it, let's go with the real granite. Drink good coffee every morning. It comes from a place that's far away. When I'm done, I feel like talking without you here. There is less to say. I don't want you thinking I'm unhappy. What is closer to I was 102. I just don't think I'll ever get over you. I'm no longer moved to drink strong whiskey. And I shoot the hand of time that I knew. But if I live till I could no longer climb my stairs, I just don't think I'll ever get over you. Haunts me. Your laughter is still ringing in my ears. I still find pieces of your presence here. Even after don't get asked to dinner, 'cause I'm here to say that I sometimes do. Even though I may soon feel the touch of love, I just don't think I'll ever get over you. But if I live till I was 102, I just don't think I'll ever get over you.